evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Carolyn's Corner Live. I am so glad you're all here with us tonight, like I am every single week. I appreciate it. I have confidence and faith in all of you that if you're not here, you're on your way. So before we start the show each week, I like to verify to make sure I have everything set properly. Unfortunately, I cannot do that until we actually start. If there was another way to do it, believe me, I wish I knew how to do it. I'd like to welcome a very special guest. First of all, a guest host. Hopefully y'all remember him. Please say hi to Mr. Jerry Bradley. Woohoo! Jerry, can you hear us? Uh-oh. Jerry, they're having some bad weather in places today. So, Jerry, can you say something, sir? Gotta be kidding me. Well, we're gonna give Jerry a minute. Jerry, you're doing the max head drum thing again. You're going dung, dung, dung. Try it again, sir. And while he's trying to get that resolved, and we were just together on the computer, it just, once you go live, I think everything flies out the window. I'd like to introduce our very special musical guest, and gosh, am I excited. Please help me welcome Crimson Calamity. Hi, ladies.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for
having
us. How
are y'all doing?
We're doing well. Yeah, weather's been crazy. We're in Nashville and it's been
tornado watch.
Yeah,
y'all think we have it bad, folks. They're in a tornado watch where they are. I'm trying to get this set and I do apologize. They've made some changes to the way this works, so I can't set it to public before. I have to wait till it starts and it's a pain in the patootie, as if you know what I'm saying. But hopefully everyone is able to see that. Could someone give me a comment and let me know? I see we have three people watching. Can someone watching please say hello or anything so I can see if the comments are working? I really need your help with this because we're having some issues. Jerry, oh, Jerry disappeared. I guess he's working on his computer. Let's hope he gets back. Golly, because I know he wants to be in this interview. He's so excited. Jerry Bradley is the one that told me about you guys and led you our way. And I am so grateful that he did that. He's just an incredible singer, songwriter himself. He's written some beautiful songs. I know you know that.
Yeah, I do. Actually, I have a CD right over here.
Isn't it great? And he's been sharing and sending so many talented people our way. I'm just beyond blessed. I really am. I'm still trying to find this because it's giving me a hard time.
Hi, Nan. Well,
oh, my Aunt Nancy said hello.
Hello. Did she? Oh, good. I can see you, Nancy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I was wondering. Okay, here we go. Now I can see it. It's like it takes a minute to catch up with it.
Yeah, there's always like a delay.
Yeah, and it drives me crazy. Nancy, thank you so much for being here. I'm trying to set these all to public because I don't want it to be only going to me. Unfortunately, I have like three different Facebooks because we've been through a couple of them and I didn't want to lose any viewers. So I said, well, let's just add it to there. So I have to make sure and go through each one real quick and make sure they're all set to public. Sorry about that. All right. I hope I have them all. All right. Thank you so much, Nancy from Utah. Wow. All the way from Utah. That's so awesome. I wonder what the weather is like there. Is it cold and yucky there too? I bet it was
cold and snowy last time we were there. A couple weeks ago.
Oh, yes.
Oh my gosh. Wow. It's just crazy. This weather is unbelievable. You never know. One part of the country, you have tornadoes. The next part, you have snow. And then over here, we're like in between hot and cold.
Yeah. Wow. We're between hot and cold ourselves here.
Golly. Well, I'm so glad that we were able to do this in spite of the weather conditions. I was concerned. I was like, well, it's cold and we're having, because we tried to get my sister a phone activated today and it was, their computer system was down. The grocery store was down. Cold there. I bet it is. Oh my gosh. I'm not going to complain because it's in the 50s here and I'm freezing. So y'all, I'm a Texas girl. We ain't used to that kind of, as they say, we ain't used to that kind of cold.
When we lived in LA, that's California cold. It's legitimately cold. When it's that cold.
Absolutely. But you know what? It is different. It is a different cold. The closer you live by the coast, I think that
it's true. It is a different cold.
The humidity and all that. Yep. So ladies, and while we're waiting on Jerry, and God, I hope he can make it back. I'm just so sad, but he'll come back. If he's able to, he will. Why don't we start off tonight by y'all telling us a little bit about yourselves? First of all, I want to make sure I have the names correct. So your name is Crimson Calamity. That's the name of your duo, your group.
Yeah.
But you have other names.
Yeah, we have our own names.
We have our own names.
You have your own names. That's not on your birth certificate. Okay, so let's see. Mallory, you are with the dark hair. I hate to refer to you as
That's okay.
That is Mallory.
Than your hair.
Yes, I know. They're close. And then next to you, we have Miss Lauren. Yes. So why don't you start by telling us a little bit about yourself, whatever you feel comfortable sharing about whatever you'd like to share. Go ahead. Okay. You have the floor.
Well, we met in college in California in musical theater school. And we became a band in 2014. We were doing a monthly songwriting challenge. We had already been writing quite a bit together. She and Mallory and I and a couple other girls are in LA. And we wrote.
We used to write together, sing together, tour together. Yep. As a group and together and like separately.
Different iterations.
Yeah. It was just like a little female empowerment music group, yeah. I guess. And we belonged to a kind of songwriting society where every month they would send out a different challenge. And so one month it would be like, I remember the Valentine's one was write either a makeup or a breakup song. Like that was, you had to pick one or the other.
Yeah.
But the month that we decided to become a band, it was summertime, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And we were given the challenge, write about a historical figure or event. And we were kind of like, at the time,
that is a challenge.
Like, what's really funny is I feel like if that happened now, I'd be like, okay, we've got a lot.
Oh, we do have a lot. Yeah,
but back then, nothing was going on in a current event that was sparking our interest. And so we were kind of thinking like, okay, what should we write about? And we tossed a few ideas around. And Lauren had been watching Deadwood at the time.
Okay.
And, oh, hi, Janet. My aunt Janet.
I know, isn't that sweet? Love this Calamity. I know, yeah, me too. Me too. Go ahead.
Anyway, Lauren had been watching the television show Deadwood, which is about Calamity Jane, you know, Wild Bill and the gunfighters and Deadwood, South Dakota and all of that. And she was like, well, what if we wrote about Calamity Jane? And I was like, ooh, that's actually really cool. And I'm from Utah, so the Wild West is near and dear to my heart as well. It was more of a mining town and a railroad town, but we still have our own stories. And I was like, yeah, that actually, I could get behind that. And so
we each came up with an idea
with our own concept, and we ended up writing two songs. And while that was happening, we were just kind of like, hey, this is something. Like, yeah, we what turned from writing sessions and just hanging out as friends into like 4-hour long meetings about like what the stage plot would look like and what our wardrobe would look like and what the branding would be and and how we could make it, you know, into something really cool. We just both got really excited about it, and it was just kind of a no-brainer. And so we kept writing songs, and we're still here a decade later, pretty much doing the same thing.
And that's why our name is Crimson Calamity as well, because we used her as our
name.
That
was on my list to ask you, because it's such a cool name. And I wondered that. Wow, that is so cool. So you realized that you had this, maybe this shared passion, maybe you were so similar, but yet maybe we talk about this all the time, how one person's maybe strengths can cover for another person's weaknesses and vice versa.
Definitely.
Is that true with the two of you as well? Yeah. Like, you know, maybe one does. Yeah. Right. So,
Absolutely. So
what do, like Mallory, for example, are you better at doing the melody, the lyrics? Y'all work on the lyrics together. How does that work?
I think that,
Hi Lauren.
I definitely gravitate.
That's my mom.
Hey,
Thank you for being here.
I gravitate towards a melody first, but I think we both like both things.
Yeah, we both.
The both things are very important to us, but I oftentimes will hear a melody before I hear what the lyric is to it.
And I think I'm.
And she's very
the opposite, maybe.
Well, you're very good about like conceptual. You're good with like a visual concept that, or like an abstract concept that then turns into either a title or a lyric. Jump off of.
Yeah. Wow. And I like will pick up on a lyric and be like, oh, I love that. You know, like I'll just kind of hone in on the lyrics. But I'd say we're both definitely like we're really, I mean, we've been writing now for like, you know, over a decade together. So
that's wrong.
Yeah.
That's
so we're, it's pretty much like a safe space at this point where we can just,
that's okay.
It's like a safe space.
Yes. I was just going to say, between the two of us, we have one full human brain. So where one is lacking, the other has the other side.
We often call ourselves the Olsen twins because we will just say the same thing at the same time.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Well, you almost have to be like that, don't you? You have to be so in tune to each other. First of all, let me interrupt you again because I've got to say hello to our dear supporter and friend, Marie McConaughey.
Hi, Marie.
She is wonderful, ladies. She supports every musician I've never heard of. She's sending me people from all over Texas and beyond. Incredible. Yes. Thanks for finding us, Marie. Yeah, it seems like we were kind of lost in the abyss for a little bit, but I'm so glad you found us. I'm going to put her little comment up on the screen. Okay, please keep going. What I was going to say is it's almost, don't you kind of have to be that way? Because you're trusting each other with delivering this. To me, a song is a story. I mean, it's a whole story of something, whether you personally went through it or not, and you have to really trust the other person. I mean, I just think it's so cool. I just can't get over that, how you two can come together and make such beautiful music and beautiful lyrics and songs. I think it's so incredible that y'all were brought together. I think it's amazing. I love it.
Thank you very much. Yeah, we feel like it was definitely, is clandestine the right word for that? Like we feel like it's definitely meant to be.
Yeah, and we're always talking about that on the show constantly. We're talking about... Always, we talk about how life is a giant quilt. A friend of mine years ago said that, and each person is in one of their own little square, and you never know where you're going to run into that square. You know, it seems funny, but it's kind of like that. And when you're meant to come together, you know, eventually you do. So I'm not going to ask specifics. Believe me, yes, I can see this. Ravioli,
ha ha ha, or something.
Is that ravioli?
I don't know either.
We're on Twitch. Thank you for being here. We don't have much of an audience on Twitch yet. We're trying to fill it up. Hello. How are you?
I love ravioli. So
yeah, I do too. I haven't had any.
Ravioli is delicious.
Can't wait for you to see this. Oh my goodness. So, it's been over a decade then that y'all have been singing together, writing together, performing together.
And we moved to Nashville in 2016 from Los Angeles, and we've been here almost 7 years, which is crazy. And,
oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So I can just like imagine.
What is
the biggest place you've played so far? Was it an arena? Have you gotten to arenas yet?
No,
we haven't gotten to an arena yet, but
we've played some amphitheaters. Festivals. Yeah, amphitheaters.
Outdoor. Wow. It's an outdoor venue, whatever the biggest one is, because you can fit more people, turns out, outside.
Yeah. Wow.
So, yeah.
I can't imagine how thrilling that must be. I mean, because I'm a lyricist myself, and just to know that your songs are being heard by that many people, it just... You know, and we've been fortunate enough to meet so many wonderful, talented people. And it's just like, gosh, especially somebody that's so good like you guys are. It's just like, man, you want them to get to that next level. Like, what can we do? What can we do to help? Because you're sending these great messages with these wonderful lyrics and wonderful songs. And we want you to get there as quickly as we can. So hopefully you'll get a little bit more notoriety here, too. We can get you some more shows.
Absolutely. We appreciate it. Yeah. Honestly, the best way to do it is to just talk to musicians and, you know, tell people about musicians you love. And it's clear that your viewers and listeners do that. So that's really cool.
Yes, they really, really do. And I already know without a doubt, because it's like we've become a family. So many of us on the show, I already know they're going to love you guys. And that's why I'm so excited. I'm really excited. So what would you classify your genre? Are you country? What would you classify yourselves?
Yeah.
Go ahead. I would say we're Americana. The direction we're sort of heading in is a little bit more folk. Folk pop, I would say, even. Dare to say, with a little bit of country,
we like to play around. We like to bend genre for sure, which Americana is a genre that allows you to do that.
Right.
Thank you, Roland.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
Roland is another dear friend of ours, and I'm glad to see him on. Thank you, Roland. You're in for a treat. Don't go anywhere. We're going to play some of their videos. We got some surprises. Go ahead. I'm sorry, sweetie.
Oh, you're totally fine. I would say at the heart of things, the probably main three genres that we touch on are folk, rock, and a little country here and there.
There's a little Americana country, which is more
of an alt country.
Yeah, like roots based.
Yeah, absolutely. Wow. And I love folk music. I love your sound because what I'm noticing is all these great musicians, singer songwriters, they're blending the genres together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I just think it's so great, but there's so many subcategories now. It's very,
like, it's such a broad umbrella. Even I think that when, you know, like when they say genre is dead, it's kind of true. And that's why,
yes,
like Americana is such a broad spectrum. It's like everything from Brandi Carlile to, like, I don't know, Sierra Farrell, which is, like, to me, very different.
Absolutely. Well, it's interesting because they're both Americana artists, but, like, Brandi got nominated for Best Rock Performance.
Yeah.
And
isn't that weird?
And I just think it depends on the song, really. Like, yeah. And these days, the song is king. You know, the record used to be king, and then it became the cassette and then the CD. And these days, the single, the song itself is what is put out more often than not. More artists are putting out singles rather than full records. And so I think that allows artists to play a bit more because you're directing each song in a specific direction. And
we love an album.
But that's one thing that I like about that landscape is that you're able to play around a bit more.
Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely. Wow. Well, I've got fortunate enough to be able to hear a little bit of your songs when I was making the little commercial. Now, I purposely don't normally listen to the entire songs because my thing is I want to be surprised just like the listeners and viewers at home are, because I love a good lyric. I love a good song. And I already know yours just, I was like, oh my God. And your harmonies, y'all, I put my hand to my face. I need to quit doing that. I'm just like, oh my God. Like, oh my God. So good. Was that natural or do y'all have to practice at that a lot?
Both is the answer.
Yes, both.
Wow.
Yeah. We both, I think, you know, nodding to theater, like you learn quite a bit about that, but we also are both not afraid of hard work. And that's one thing I really love about my bandmate is she's not afraid to get crazy with me and like do the more complicated harmony and and spend time working it out.
Let's just do it.
And really woodshed. Oh, excuse me.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. We're attached.
I'm Italian.
I know. I love that. Y'all are attached. I think that's so great. It's so great.
It's just like woodshed everything because you know, like you can, a lot of people develop an ear where they can harmonize along in the moment and improvise. And I think that there's so much value in that as well, but we really try to pride ourselves on being very intentional with our harmonies
We're two part harmony, which can sometimes be more difficult to make sound full and not just go for like the simple thing. Like three part can sometimes be easier to find. You could find the third, you know, a little bit easier.
You can find the third. I cannot harmonize. I have tried. And it is very difficult for me. I mean, I have tried and tried. I finally just said,
skill.
You know what? It is absolutely a skill. Absolutely a skill. Wow. So do y'all have a full band or is it just you two? I mean, I don't mean that in a bad way because no matter what it is. Do y'all have a full band yet or no?
We do. We have we're flexible. We can do like we're playing at City Winery here in Nashville on March 5th and we're playing acoustic, just the two of us. But then we also have an accessories player who's playing some fancy guitar and some mandolin and dobro and stuff with us. We have all the way up to a six piece. So,
yeah. So it just depends on the show.
Yeah.
We love to play full band shows. I think we have probably the most fun when we're doing that, but we love playing acoustically too. It's just like we like to play the genre. We like to play with the setup of our bands.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
We're playing around with some new stuff too. So,
I can just imagine. Oh my gosh. And well, it's great that you have that option. So if someone wants to hire you for just an acoustic gig, okay, I got you. Somebody wants a full band, you know, you got it. You got everything you need. And I think that is so great. I'd like to say hi also to Dale Hestelo.
He's up near
Waco, Texas, where I'm from originally in Central Texas. Welcome, Dale. Thank you for being here. Thank you. And for everyone who is tuning in and listening and watching, thank you so much for being here. Now, I want to share something with y'all real quick. When we did the radio show on Monday, as always, I was featuring three artists' songs that had been on the podcast. And I reiterated the importance of like, comment, and share. And I did not know the difference that was going to make. That show had 7 shares, and we normally don't get that many shares. That doesn't sound like a lot, but to me it was a lot. And because of that, we reached over 3,000 people from that show.
That's awesome.
That blew my mind. And I posted on Facebook. I was like, look what we can do.
Yeah.
Look what we can do, you know, because we're in this little corner of the world, basically. That's why it's called Carolyn's Corner, trying to make a difference. And look at the reach that we got. I think the more people that share, the more people that like, the more people that comment, all of it is integrated together. And then Facebook or YouTube looks at those numbers and then they'll send it out to more people. Yep. So I want to restate again to please anyone who is watching, everyone that is watching, please like, comment, and share. And honestly, I found out for myself last week what a huge difference that makes, because I want to get these beautiful ladies out to as many people as we can and help them get more notoriety and help them get more shows. And next thing you know, we'll be watching the awards and see y'all on the award show.
And they're listening to God's ears. Yep.
Yes. Yes. I believe that. I believe, but because I really believe that if we all come together for one cause, we can make a big difference.
It's so true. Strength in numbers. So,
yeah, and I'm sorry Jerry's not made it back yet. I'm so sad about that. Hopefully he's at least watching.
Hopefully he can pop in at some point.
Okay, Dale said he'll be right back. And I appreciate every. You need to play some music before Poppy washes my hand away. Oh, yeah, she has her little chihuahua that's with her, the miniature chihuahua. He watches everything. He goes everywhere with her.
Oh my God.
The first song I'm going to play tonight, ladies, is a song called Ghost. Why don't y'all tell us a little bit about that song, and we'll get to play in the videos.
Yes, sure.
Did you wrote what Roland wrote? Let me wrote.
Sure. Yeah, they sound beautiful. Thank you so much.
I know. He's such a sweetheart. Yes, go ahead. I'm sorry.
We wrote that song. We wrote Ghost in LA with a production team that we often work closely with, Nicole Funicelli and Shayon Daniels. And we recorded it here in Nashville. And actually, we recorded it here in Nashville, but we also were fortunate enough to have an incredible guitarist in LA play on it, Zane Carney. He's toured with John Mayer.
Johnny Lang.
Yeah. He's wow. Incredible. Yeah.
Look him up for sure.
Definitely look him up. He's in a band with Evan Rachel Wood. And he also has his own music and he does jazz and all this. He's incredible. But
oh, goodness.
So the song is about the idea that even if after a relationship has ended, sometimes the feelings are lingering and you're just like, please, like, leave me alone. Stop haunting me. Go away.
Yes.
But I'm never going to tell you to do that. So you have to be the one to go. And
nice.
Yeah, that's sort of
the linger, as we call it.
The linger.
Yeah. That is nice. I like the premise of that. So anything else y'all would like to add about it before we play this video? And by the way, the video is, oh my God.
Oh yeah. I guess maybe about the video, it was directed by Mike Darling. He's based here in Nashville now. And we were lucky enough to have two really incredible Nashville dancers in the video.
Yes.
And
Catrell and Anna are the dancers, and Lizzie Clark was the choreographer, and they did just a beautiful job.
They did. And we kind of conceptualized it all ourselves.
Wow.
And, yeah.
I love it. I could not stop watching it. I was like, we're not supposed to be watching this. I told my sister, I said, but I'm going to cheat and we're going to watch it. So
actually, we should shout out to our stylist too. We had a stylist.
It was like a movie set in there, wasn't it?
It felt like that. It was definitely our most professional set to date.
That must have been so exciting. I mean, definitely. Really. And I know I heard that they're grueling. It takes a long time.
We banged it out in like, well, a lot of it in like, I think 2 days. We did
the majority of the filming.
Most of it in 2 days, but you know, there's pre-production and all that stuff too. Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I know y'all are so excited. You're not going to want to miss this. Here is the first song, Ghost, by Crimson Calamity. Here we go.
Tell you to go. see you. You're the darkness in all of my dreams. Light a candle, turn the light on. Yeah, you linger, you're still here with me. Wish you would leave on.
I know. I'm so glad he made it back. Let me get this off the screen. I guess I clicked it. I got the clickies. I was telling the ladies before the show I had the clickies. Okay. Welcome back, Jerry.
Oh, I've never been flexible like Henry. Never.
Ladies. Oh my gosh. I mean, that song is your voices. I don't even know what to say. Jerry, can you hear us?
Jerry? I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
We can hear you. Welcome, Jerry. So I don't know what happened. Okay, so while you're, go ahead.
I just want to say this. Have you ever seen me so excited for a guest that was coming on, and then have things go wrong?
It never fails, Jerry. I know Jerry has been trying to so excited, and me too. Because I knew you were great. When he told me, he said, wait, just wait. I was like, oh my God. And Jerry's never wrong when it comes to music. You were right on the money. It's funny. Speaking of money, I got eyeballs on my face so nobody can see my, that's okay. Nobody needs to see my ugly mug anyway. Man, that song. Wow. Oh my gosh. Jerry, what are your thoughts on that? And we're not here to criticize. I just, that's beyond, oh gosh. Go ahead, Jerry. Let you deal with it.
I don't know. I just came on, Carolyn. I know their song. So which song was it that we played?
We played Ghost.
Oh, that's an awesome song.
Yes, it is. Marie said such harmony, so complimentary to each other. God.
Thank you.
Wow. You know what? That's almost hard to even come up with words. Let me see what and Dale, I'm so glad that you're okay. flexible like him. Oh, Marie said, I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
Flexible like him. Hi, Jerry. Pretty song and video. Thank you, Sarah. Roland, my friend Roland said, that was hot. That's a good word, Roland. And we have a guest on Twitch. Thanks for being here, Roland. You're awesome. He said, hey, what's up? Well, not much, James. We're just doing a live podcast, Carolyn's Corner Live. I'm glad you're joining us. This is our guest tonight in the top right corner. I guess it's your right. Crimson Calamity. And down below on the bottom is Jerry Bradley, my co-host tonight. And we're just hanging out with friends, listening to some great music. I'm so glad you tuned in. I want to remind you all again to please, it makes a difference, y'all. Like, comment, share, especially share. Come on, do it for us. Yeah, it's a good video, isn't it, Dale? Oh, my gosh. How is your streaming going? Good, James. Thank you. Thank you, James. I appreciate it. So let me see here. Thank you. I hope you'll keep tuning in. Them ladies got a good voice. Yes, they do now. That's straightforward. Them ladies got a good voice. Wow. That song is beautiful. And you said you had y'all came up with a concept yourself, huh?
A music video concept. Yeah. Yeah, we did.
Really, really cool. Haunting and cool. And it just, it's so beautiful. I thought it was so, so beautiful.
Thanks so much.
God. It's hard for me to come up with adjectives to describe a song when it's that good. I mean, you guys should be on on a stage somewhere big, like in a dang, stadium or something. You should definitely.
Yeah. Red Rocks.
We're having to pay lots and lots of money to come to hear you. You guys are amazing. Jerry, what would you like to add? Anything, sir? I'm trying to make sure I got.
Yeah, well, I see. I'm sorry for coming. Technical difficulties. I don't know if you've covered this already. You know, ladies are much more than singer-songwriter. I mean,
yes.
Producers, pianists, mentor, mentors, coach. Harry is doing lessons. I think she actually offered to give me guitar lessons. Ouch.
Wow. But,
at one point.
He's like, I don't need them.
At that time, she didn't know.
That is true.
That's good.
Did you guys get into that? Why don't you talk?
What was that? We didn't talk about that yet. No, we didn't.
No, we didn't, Jerry. Thank you for bringing that up. So you're multifaceted. Are you singers, musicians, both of you play?
You have to get creative these days as an independent musician. Yeah. In the band Mallory, we're sort of working out some new stuff where I'm starting to play some synth and everything like that. Cause I do play piano, but
I'm going to make her play a different instrument on every song.
Yeah. Piano is my main instrument, and Mallory plays piano way better than me and guitar. And she teaches both, and voice and songwriting. And
I coach musical theater auditioners. And yeah. I did the data, and I actually have a 88% callback return on the kiddos.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really fun. I love doing
that's
it.
That's pretty good. Dang, that's amazing. And to me, looking at you, I'm not going to ask, but you look so young to have accomplished so much. I think that's incredible. You both are just so nice young. Really, y'all look great. I mean, you've gotten a lot accomplished in your lives already. You should be very, very proud of yourself. I'm proud of you, and I just barely met you. But to me, you're part of our family now. Jerry knows that. Once you're in our family, no matter if you like it or not, you're stuck with us. At least we'll still be around, good Lord willing, and the cream don't rise. Jerry, anything you want to add before we get to the next song? That was my husband said something.
He's not on camera, so, do you do videos?
I own my own media company called Dance Magic Media, and because I'm it's called Dance Magic because of the movie Labyrinth, because I'm a huge David Bowie fan. I do lyric videos, and visualizer videos and social media content, and then I do brand consulting for other artists and and social media management. So kind of doing all that stuff on top of running our social media and stuff like that too.
Wow.
So, yeah.
And you also have your own studio.
I did say David Bowie. I love David Bowie and I love the movie Labyrinth. It's my favorite of all time. So my company is called Dance Magic Media.
Dance Magic.
Dance, oh my magic, God. Dance. So you're doing all of that on top of everything else. That's incredible.
Yeah.
You're just that's going, how we pay the bills. You are so busy. You are so busy. That's incredible.
Yeah, we are.
That's
we
a
are
lot. That is very busy.
But because we both work for ourselves, we can, you know,
it definitely
gives us a little bit more flexibility and.
Yes, absolutely. So my husband is watching from the other room and he said, that was a great production. Outstanding. I got chills.
Thank you.
And I knew he would because he's seen it on the big screen. I'm having to look on this little screen. I should maximize it. But then, hello, Rhonda Kay. Sweet. You remind me of the babe. Let's see.
That's from Labyrinth.
You remind me of the babe. Is that what it says? Okay, I'm sorry. I just saw that. All right. Thank you.
Later, we'll be reenacting the entire movie of Labyrinth.
Oh, wow.
Stay tuned. We're in for a treat.
I love it. I love it. So, Jerry, anything you want to add about that song or any other questions before we get to the next song?
No, but I do want to point out, I was talking to Paul Gibney on Notes Fire Radio. We kind of mentioned what was going to be going on here tonight on Carolyn's Corner. Paul's probably out there and watching. But one of the things I talked about when it came to Lauren, and you know, as a fairly new somebody's just finally got a single on the radio, no matter when I went, hey, could you listen to this for me, or could you look this for me, let me know what you think, give me some feedback, never hesitate. Wow. So many, I'm not throwing stones at anybody, but I don't know of anybody else that's in Nashville that would do that for Jerry Bradley, you know?
You're right. Wow.
And not even hesitate. Just wonderful, wonderful people. Absolutely.
Oh, thank you, Jerry.
I got to know Lauren first, and then I got to know Mallory.
Wow, that is great. That shows the character of you guys. And that contributes to your success because you treat others the way you want to be treated. And if you do good, good will come to you for sure.
Yeah. And it's always about lifting up, you know, lifting other artists up, and it's not a competition. Everybody has something unique to share and to bring to the world.
Oh, that is great.
You know,
so Roland asked a good question. Is your video on YouTube?
Yes, it is. Yeah. All of our videos
on your. Tell them, is it under Crimson Calamity
on YouTube?
Crimson
Calamity on YouTube, yeah.
Okay.
And I will also say, just to add to the things that we do, we also have a podcast of our own called The Liner Notes with Crimson Calamity.
Oh, see, I didn't know that.
Yeah. We
currently just an audio podcast.
Yes, an audio podcast.
But you can find it online, and we do put the performances from the podcast up on our YouTube channel as well. And it is, we like to say it's an audio capsule. We don't get the records or the cassettes or the CDs anymore. So we don't get to leaf through the liner notes and look at the pictures and the little, you know, poetic mentions and things like that, like we used to. And so we wanted to create an audio version of that. Hi, Mama. My mama just joined.
Oh, how nice. Hi, Mom.
We love you, too. We don't get that anymore. So we wanted to create an audio version of that and just make sure that artists today that are working so hard to put their content out there are able to really do a deep dive and talk about why they did it. And
it's nice to talk about it with other musicians, too. So it's like we're just kind of having like a, we keep it very casual and have like a conversation from musician to musician.
Play some music.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Wow, that's
great. You know, that's the week.
We do.
That's what it should be. To me, it should be like that because, like you said, it's not a competition. That is so refreshing to hear that because I think a lot of the musicians and the bands out there are trying to compete against all the other ones. And I think if you just come together, because we're all in it for the same reason, to me, you know, you're all in it for the same reason, to entertain and make people smile and make them cry, bring emotion to them. So why not come together? If you're all doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Yes, we are on Spotify, Apple Music, all the things. You can find us on pretty much any musical platform. And we're on Instagram and TikTok and Facebook. Crimson C Music, the letter C.
Oh.
Yeah. Crimson Sea Music.
I didn't get that on there right. Let me fix it. Crimson Sea Music. Let me fix that.
Somebody had taken Crimson Calamity. I think there's a video game that says something about Crimson.
Yep, there is for sure.
And so somebody had taken it. So we just went with Crimson Sea Music on all the things.
Okay, so that's where they're going to find everything.
Yeah. Pretty much all of our handles are Crimson Sea Music.
Okay, that makes it way better. They can find it for sure. Okay, good. Let me change that. And it's all together, right? Oh, I guess I'll just leave it separate.
Yeah.
We'll just leave it separate. Whoa, come back here. I'm adding it as we speak because I didn't have it all in here yet. There we go. Let me put this back up on the screen, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure y'all write this down, okay?
At Crimson Sea Music, yeah. And it's all together.
Okay. They can find it. I can find it, I guess. I believe that whoever that is on Twitch is a robot thing. Thank you for asking, Roland. Yes, they are on all music streaming platforms. And how many releases do you have out there now? You've been doing this a while.
We have 3 EPs out as of now.
A Christmas single.
And then, we're writing right now for our new project, which will be a collection of EPs that will become a full album/vinyl project. So,
It's ambitious.
Yeah, it's going to be 4 EPs.
Oh my gosh.
One album. Yeah.
That's incredible. And to think that you've created all of that. I mean, that's just pretty amazing. It really is. You've created a whole storybook, a whole life full of stories. So let's get to the next song. The next song is Fool's Gold. Tell us a little bit about that. I like the sound of the name.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Fool's Gold is a song about the temptations we can all get caught up in, or maybe we've observed others getting caught up in. And at the end of the day, the people that surrender to those temptations are humans too. And it's just a fun romp. Like, it's not meant to be taken very seriously.
But it's sort of like
a cautionary tale.
Yeah. Like, at the end of you could chase after all the material things, but
that's
you're just going to end
gold.
Up. Yeah. That's the fool's gold.
Like, friendship and connection and love are the real gold.
Right.
Amen. That's true. That is so true. Matt, let's see. Marty says, these women are so busy, I got to say. Yeah.
My mom knows how busy I am because sometimes I don't answer the phone for a minute.
Yeah. Sorry, that's the thing. It's like, when you own your own business, you have flexibility, but
when you
own multiple businesses, you're working 24/7.
You don't have time to even breathe hardly. So right. Jerry, anything you want to add about this song, Fool's Gold, before I play it, or anything else you want to add before we play it? Jerry, are you frozen up again?
Am I? Can you?
No, you're good now.
Yes, now we can.
I need to not move so much. My camera's freaking out. We don't want me getting into things because it's a beautiful night and I don't want to, you know me, if I get good guests on that I really like, I'll be in here drilling them forever. What did you think about this? All the songs that they have a lot, and I love all their music. Fool's Gold is probably, you've got over 25,000 streams on that one song alone?
It's been our little dark horse, yes, I think.
Yes, you do. I know. I looked it up today. So just, it's a wonderful song. I love it.
I can't wait. So without further ado, folks, here we go. Here is Fool's Gold by Crimson Calamity.
Met a man in Reno, made a money and charm. He mistook the Joker for the Queen of Hearts. No, he couldn't see through my disguise. Give me a rock and I was ready to roll on to California with the guy named Joe, 'cause he makes Benjamins rain from the sky. It's a thirst I just can't quench. It's an itch I just can't scratch. God forgive me for the life I've been living. I'm doing time in a five-star prison. Get my kicks, but it's taking its toll. The devil took my soul, dangling the fool's gold. Men in Manhattan swept me off of my feet. Woke up at the plaza in a penthouse suite, but just like Wall Street, I turned on a dime. Oh, I flew to Miami, that's when I met Ramon. He taught me how to salsa between shots of Patron, but in the morning he left no goodbye. Oh, there's a fever with no chill. Oh, it's a void I just can't.
Oh, that was so beautiful. Jerry, I'll let you take this one. Go ahead. What is Marie saying?
Marie, that's so sorry. I was just reading Marie's comment. That's so nice. Thank you.
Wow. Yeah, that is nice. Let me put those up on the screen. Roland said, wow, that's a good description. Wow. Let me read that out loud again. I'm sorry. I can't think of any groups I've heard that are as complimentary to each other as these gals. This is an awesome song. I agree, Marie. I completely agree. And Roland says it best. Wow. Roland, great choice of words, because it's almost beyond words. Go ahead, Jerry.
No, I need to correct what I said, because what I said was they've had over 25,000 streams on this song. They've had over 25,923 to be exact on Spotify.
Oh my goodness.
Not counting the other streaming platforms. That's just on Spotify on this one song, which you can see this song is awesome. I mean the production, the music, the blending of the vocals, the harmonies, it is you know, when you look at it from listening to the lyrics, which are wonderful lyrics, but you look at the whole picture, it's like, and they do all that.
It's amazing.
They do all that.
Absolutely. Amazing. Well, Roland said, was that the entire band that you mentioned earlier?
The guy who's playing guitar, he's played with us a couple times, but that's not like our all the time iteration of our band. But when we did that song in the studio, one of the things that you're hearing is not necessarily electric. It's not an electric guitar. It's actually a fiddle through a guitar pedal, through an effects pedal.
That kind of screamy sound that you hear is a fiddle being played through a pog fuzz pedal.
Now I don't know much about, I don't know anything about fiddle, but I don't think I've heard of that. Is that something?
Well, we kind of just were experimenting. That's one of those like weird, crazy things that we just tried in the studio and it sounded really cool. And
it was one of those days where like I really love that EP because it was captured mostly live. And we've been lucky enough to do that actually with all three of our EPs for the most part, for the bones of the songs.
Yeah.
And we ended up with extra time and it was just kind of like a thing where it's like, hey, we need something here. What does it sound like if you plug that into that? And then when, you know, we had a guy named Zach Rundquist, who's just an incredible multi-instrumentalist. He played a lot of the guitar and the fiddle on
our most recent, both recent albums,
the last two EPs that we've released. And so we plugged that in to our lead guitar player's pedal, and it was just like the coolest sound we'd ever heard. And we were like, that has to stay.
Yeah.
So we ended up with a longer outro than I think we ever anticipated on, but I'm not mad at
no,
it.
I love it.
No, I love it. I love the song. It is so great. All of it sounds perfect. So I want to touch on this comment that you see on the bottom. he said, damn it, Carolyn, because when I do my karaoke show, we do our karaoke show at the VFW for the veterans and all the people there. He is one of our great people that come in. He and his wife, they're great people. They make me laugh and smile. But it seems like every time I'm there, something goes wrong with the song or the computer. And they have this little thing where they all yell it at the same time.
That's
and
so
now
funny.
If they don't say it, I'm like, what's wrong? Why are y'all so quiet? What is it's going good? Thanks for being here, Troy. I know it's Troy because his wife would never say it. Oh, my gosh. That's because they're so awesome together is what Marie said. Yeah, that's
thank
beautiful.
You, Marie. Oh, my gosh. This is like a little pick-me-up. We need this.
We appreciate
really?
It. Thank you. Being here and listening. Thank you so much.
Oh, gosh. Well, I can't imagine you getting anything other than just amazing, like, accolades because you're so talented. I could sit and listen to you all night. I really could. I would love to go see you live one of these days, but I know you're all the way in Nashville.
We'll just have to make it out to Texas.
I think we're coming to Texas in the fall. So
we are actually in October.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Really? Maybe that would be cool. My birthday's in October. Maybe we could make plans.
October what?
October the 8th.
You're a Libra.
Yes, ma'am.
I love a Libra. So
yes.
fun.
Yes. Great. Oh my gosh. That would be the highlight of my life, honestly. That is, man, y'all are so good. Nailed it. Troy said nailed it, man. For real. How do you describe something? How do you comment on something like that? Jerry, help me out here.
Yeah. I did have a question I've really been kind of wanting to ask you for a while.
Yeah, sure.
Now, you guys are in Nashville. I got that. But you didn't come from Nashville.
No. Yeah. We talked about that a little earlier. We moved to Nashville from Los Angeles, but I'm originally from Massachusetts and Mallory's originally from Utah. So...
Wow.
Yeah, we went to school in LA and lived there for a while and then moved here in 2016.
So tell me how that relationship came together.
We met in school, and after school we kind of reconnected. My younger brother was actually in the same class or same grade, I guess, however you want to classify
college
it,
class, yeah.
As she was. And they were very good friends, and I knew of her and loved her. I thought she was an amazing person.
They
and
passed, you know, hung out like passing, sort
yeah.
of, yeah,
ships in the night, so to speak,
right.
at the same social gatherings. And then, my younger brother decided to move back home to Utah and pursue some more education. He actually has his master's in English and he's writing books now, which is really cool.
Wow.
But, he at the time, he kind of said to Lauren, he's like, hey, my sister needs friends. He wasn't wrong. I really did.
But really what he didn't know is that I felt like such a strong, like, I don't even know, like, if it was some sort of providence or whatever, that I was like supposed to be her friend. And I just knew that we were supposed to be friends. And I didn't know, you know, what the capacity that we were going to be bandmates. And
I often think about how to answer this. And the best answer I can come up with is just, I don't really know how we started hanging out. I just know we didn't stop.
Yeah.
So
pretty much. And we just chat. we just like chat away. Like when we're on tour, we're in the car, we're chatting away all the time and like talking about nerdy stuff.
It's true. And I think if you can find someone you can spend more than 4 hours in a car with and not want to plant them in a lettuce patch, that's a really good sign.
that is. Yes.
And she and I mean, like, I we don't really fight very much or argue very much or anything, but when we're on the road, we pretty much never do.
Yeah.
Because it's...
We might, like, bicker like sisters, but not nothing serious.
But so I think that, in my observation, we get along the best on the road.
Wow. Go ahead,
Jerry. I've said this before to the two of you, you know, and I kind of got to know Lauren a little bit first. As I was doing writing and stuff, and she was doing some critiquing and so forth. But it's like you're of the same heart. It's amazing. And, you know, not to compare you with anybody, one of the groups I'd like to listen to is the Hall Sisters. And they do a wonderful job in harmonizing, and they play different instruments. But one of the things I found so amazing with the two of you is that you harmonize better than family.
Yeah.
It's just that is high praise, sir. Thank you.
I agree, Jerry. I agree. Wow.
Thank you. That is very praise.
Lauren said, Lauren is the sister Mallory never had. She had six brothers.
I have six broskies. Yeah. I love them all.
I have four brothers and a sister. No, three brothers and a sister.
That's probably a lot.
Three brothers and a sister.
Well, you might as well say you each have a goodness, I don't know who that is. We'll just block that. You might as well call each other sisters. I mean,
all the time if we are, and we should probably just start saying yes.
I think so, because you're so in tune with each other. I can tell you're best friends. So, would you consider yourself best friends?
Yes. Absolutely.
I see that. And also,
awkward. Like behind the curtain, she's just my coworker.
I know. We're just sharing the same headphones. I don't really like her. They really are two people with one voice. Yeah, I agree, Marie. They're just like so in tune to each other. So I was trying to do a very crappy segue like they do on the talk shows. You know how they say, y'all didn't even catch that. It was so smooth.
Well done.
But I'm using y'all more tonight. I don't know why. I usually try not to use y'all as often, but I guess
I like y'all. Y'all is inclusive. It includes everybody. Yeah, it's great.
It's y'all of you. So, oh my gosh, y'all are so
amazing. Well, that's better because you always used to do y'all.
Y'all, yes, I know. Remember I used to say YOLO. I said that one night by accident, and I kept doing it. I was like, oh my God, that's hilarious, because that's what it means, y'all. But I'm like, I kept saying it. I'm like, y'all all need to come over here. Oh my gosh. So Dale said, oh, here we go with the country slang. See, Dale already knows.
Darn King Dale.
Yes.
Listen, I'm a Yankee through and through, and I find myself, when I'm here, people ask me, they're like, can I see your ID? Or I'll be like, yes, ma'am. And I'm like, oh, who am so I?
I love it. Well, Dale knows because he's from where I was born and raised. And I say, the Waco in me is slipping out, because that's where I'm originally from in Central Texas. So once in a while, it just comes out.
My mom, who's watching.
Go ahead.
No, I just said my mom, who's watching, was born in Baytown.
Nice. Right by
Houston. She has lots of Texas-isms that she likes to share. Yeah.
Texas-isms.
Yep.
Ooh, I like that. I like
my
that.
My favorite one is when somebody burps if they say, did I get any on ya?
I haven't heard that one. Did I get any on ya?
Get any on ya?
That's a good one. I might have to use that one. I'll let my husband use it. I think that people would look at me really weird if I did it. So Marie said, y'all is my first, middle, and last name. I use it constantly. And Dale said, I say it all the time. I know, so do I. You ain't kidding, Dale. Oh, my gosh. So my terribly cheap trying to do the segue, I have the next song written down as My Best Friend, but I'm not sure if that's exactly the title. Is it?
Yeah, it's My Best Friends with an S, yeah.
Oh, sorry. My mom was born in Houston, not Baytown. I think they lived in Baytown at one point, or she did.
Okay.
I get it mixed up. I apologize.
That's all right. Well, you know, it's funny you said Houston, because my son, every time he hears me say the word Houston, he stops me. Mom, it is not Houston with a W. It's Houston. I can't even say it. And I don't know why I had to tell you that. It's just a funny thing between us. Mom, it's not Houston. It's Houston. Anyway, whatever.
I love it.
Yeah, it's hard to say some of these words. So the next song that we have is My Best Friend. Tell us a little bit about this song.
So My Best Friends was written years before we became a band, actually. Okay. And we were in another songwriting challenge.
It was like a camp.
It was like a songwriting camp. And we had to pick a word out of a hat, or it was actually a styrofoam cup. And the word we got was grass, and we were paired off, and the word we got was grass. So we wrote this song with two other people, our buddy James Longstreet and this guy Layton.
And it was one of those things where we were like, we needed songs to fill time once when we first became a band, and we played it and people went crazy. And we were,
and
like,
they were like, play that song, play that. Okay. And play that Mary Jane song.
We kept playing it. And then we were like, well, I guess we should record it. And we did. And we had a really good time recording that song. And when it came time to make the video, we were just kind of like, what are we going to do?
And Mallory had a brilliant idea. I don't even know if I should say it. Here. I feel like we should just
just let it speak for itself.
Mallory had the idea for the concept. That you will surprise everybody.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, because the word was grass. Okay, this is going to be interesting. Jerry, anything you want to add before? I'm really excited to see this. I'm like, what? I have not seen a bit of this. Jerry, do you know about this song?
I've heard the song. I've listened to it. Absolutely. Okay. But, you know, it's a beautiful night. So I just want to hear the song.
Absolutely. We'll talk about that when we come back. It's a beautiful night, by the way. Hi, Heather. We love you, too. Okay, here we go with My Best Friend. Here we go.
Hey, kids.
Today's about
how to survive adulthood.
Chill out, man.
Any questions?
Again.
We played it 35 times.
But it's so good.
You know what else is good?
What?
This joke.
Oh, okay, let's have it.
Okay. Why couldn't the lifeguard save the hippie?
Why not?
Because he was too far out, man.
Oh, my God. I love that. I love that. Okay, I got one. Uh-huh. All right. So I bought some shoes from a drug dealer the other day. I'm not sure what they were laced with, but I've been tripping all day.
Hey.
Oh, you still here?
The song's over.
Go home.
Seriously.
Go on now.
Beat it.
Get.
Go on.
Go on.
Let's blow this joint.
Ah, I see what you did there.
Get the skipping shot.
This is how excited I am that we're done shooting. Lawson.
I love it.
Oh my gosh. We love this. And I know I'm old, but I think I got a couple of the things you were talking about. That is really great. Jerry. Oh my gosh.
Oh, that was so much fun. And it's amazing how, you know, I'm not going to get into any of my songs or anything like that, but sometimes there'll be a song there that you're like, yeah, it's okay. Yeah. You know, I had one I was going to throw away. It just wasn't getting it, you know, and it was like, and then people just latch onto it and you're like, oh my gosh, you know, this was just for fun. I was just doing this for fun. That's amazing. I love that. And I love the way that turned out. But the song itself is really kind of serious and it's fun, but it's still,
nostalgic.
It's a wonderful story.
Yeah. It's nostalgic. It's like, I used to say it reminded me of like a Wes Anderson movie or something. Like it just kind of had this nostalgic, wistful vibe to it. And then our producer definitely added the groovy elements to it.
Yeah, she did. She's awesome. Kina Johnson. She's the best.
Y'all did such a great job on that. My husband said he had it cranked up so loud. I had to go tell him to turn it down. Literally the wall was shaking in here and I'm not kidding. I had to go, can y'all please turn it down? I had the sound bar on so loud. And, the one you don't like is usually the best. That's what Mary said.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. I can see why people are requesting that because it is just a fun song, a happy song about, you know, when you're growing up and just laying and rolling around on the grass. I loved it. I thought it was so good. I love upbeat songs like that. I loved all your songs. I'm not even kidding. Thank you very much. But yeah, I can see why that one is getting a little bit more like people are like, yeah, I just want something. Because sometimes I think people just want, they don't want necessarily something that's going to depress them necessarily.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Or to even talk about something that they're going through. They just want something to take their mind, you know, like, don't worry, be happy. You know, and that's what that song did to me. It did. Right, Jerry?
I don't think we're going to be playing tonight. Correct me if I'm wrong, please. Line them up and shoot them.
Line them down. No, we're not playing that tonight. But
that was the first one we wrote.
That was one of the two. Yeah, Line Them Up and Shoot Them Down and Dead Man's Hand were the two first songs that we wrote that made us decide to become a band. And they're both inspired by Calamity Jane.
Line Them Up and Shoot Them Down.
Yeah,
and I'm gonna have to go check that out. Line Them Up and Shoot Them Down.
The story within the song itself was just, I found it hilarious because it, you know, it was so true.
That's how it's meant to be.
Wow.
It's good when you can take a true thing and make it funny.
I just
saw the two of you with pistols on your hips. You know, just
that's how we wanted it, and we really like. Because Calamity Jane was such a character and she was like larger than life and she eventually became part of Buffalo Bill's show.
Yeah.
With Annie Oakley. Wow. She was a gunslinger. And so we wanted to really capture that.
The showmanship.
And then with Dead Man's Hand, it's sort of like a murder ballad. It's about the death of Wild Bill Hickok. And she was in love with him. It was rumored that they were married, but
who knows?
They're very next to each other. And So yeah, that song is about the dead man's hand, which is the hand that he had in his hand when he was
playing
shot
poker.
Dead.
Yeah. When he fell forward, he was unfortunately shot in the back of the head. Yeah, when he fell forward, he had the black eights and black aces in his hands, and so they call that the dead man's hand now.
Wow.
That's interesting. Yeah.
So I want to say welcome to Heather Lee Ryan. She's a past podcaster and a good friend. Yeah, she said that's hilarious. Oh my gosh, Heather, it's so good to have you on here. To see you, Heather. Gosh, it's so nice to have Heather here. She's great, y'all. She is a riot. She's really amazing lady. We have so many talented people that have been on Carolyn's Corner. It's just mind-blowing. She's definitely one of them. So, Jerry, anything you want to add before we get to another little thing we got planned?
No, but I would like, and you'll have to answer it right now, but, you know, we so often do we ask guests, you know, if you had one piece of advice that you would give to, you know, another singer-songwriter that's coming along, what would that be? And, you know, quite frankly, we get a lot of cheesy stuff because most of the people that we're interviewing, most of the time, and they're nice people, don't get me wrong, I'm not putting them down, but they just started. They don't have any advice.
Yeah, right, yeah.
But you do.
True.
Wow, that's a loaded question in some ways, but I think it's a great question. For me, I personally would say it's the two things I would want to tell a young singer-songwriter or someone just starting out is two things can be true at the same time, and that is that you got to do it because you love it first, because it's hard. And the second thing is that your dreams matter and your voice matters, and no one else is you.
Yeah.
You are your own unique fingerprint, and so what you have to say matters. And so as long as you love what you're doing, keep going. And if you hate it, stop.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Like I would, to piggyback sort of on that, is it's a really hard life. To live as a musician and you, or as an artist, a performer, and you have to love it. And if you don't, like Mallory said, you have to pick something else that you do love, find something else that you do love. But also I know it sounds sort of cliche, but like show up on time and be nice to people and be easy to work with. And that doesn't mean be a pushover. That doesn't mean like let everybody just
take advantage of you.
That just means just be
a good human.
Yeah, really.
For sure.
And don't let people push you around and take advantage of you and don't.
To add to that too, actually, I would also say that like you're still an artist. No matter what, if you consider yourself an artist, if you decide you're an artist, you're an artist. So if you write a song, you're an artist.
Yeah. It doesn't matter if you write 10 in 1 week or
it doesn't matter if you play it in your living room or for a million people, like you're an artist if you create something because no one else is going to create it the same way.
Right.
Well, with that being said though, the two of you, you know, that sounds a little hard, which I know you're not, you know, and you were talking about it, you have to love it. One of the things that Carolyn, you don't know is that they do love it. And they, a lot of times they're doing things for charity, taking their music out there and at events. What was it? The last one was for animals. I'm sorry.
Over Christmas we did, for the homeless animals. We did an event for, at the Bowery Vault. Here in Nashville, and look up the name of the exact.
Whole community came together for that. Yeah, it was really special. Cool. Wow. We should shout out the Bowery Vault. The Bowery Vault is actually the venue that you saw in the Fool's Gold video. That music venue, it is this little gem in Nashville here that has quickly become the best listening room in town, in my opinion. Vero and Emily, the owners, are definitely the best humans you could ever meet. And so they actually personally invited a bunch of artists to sing a couple of songs at the holiday time. And all the proceeds from the money raised that night went to help find homes for animals out in the cold.
Yeah,
basically.
It's actually the woman whose charity or program it is she goes and she'll take homeless pets. She won't take them from or unhoused people. She'll But she'll take them to the vet and make sure that they have all their shots, make sure that they have food and all that. So she knows that those, that they're important companions to unhoused people. And so she will just make sure that their animals are taken care of as well. Yeah.
And who else but your biggest fan would know all this good stuff about you guys?
Yeah. Oh my God.
You've got the good questions, Jerry.
Well, you know, Jerry came up with another question that he had mentioned to me or written down. Do you have, can you both tell us of someone that, who would you consider your biggest influence in your career and in your lives, actually? Kind of both, right, Jerry?
I mean, there's a lot, but I would say one that just, you know, the first thing that popped into my head was Brandi Carlile.
As an artist, as for an sure. artist. Absolutely.
So incredible. So
we asked that of our podcast guest too. But I mean, obviously, like, you know, it's like the, like, I would say my, like, my dad definitely molded my, my sound that I listened to growing up. And my mom too, obviously, but my dad more so. My dad's a singer as well. And, and then, I mean, I, like I said, David Bowie, I love me some Bowie. But everybody from like Sarah McLachlan, Sarah Bareilles is like, I was actually, I'll just kind of like briefly tell this quick story. When I was in college, I saw her perform, Sarah Bareilles perform live with just her at a keyboard. And I just started sobbing when she sang her song Gravity. And I was like, this is what I need to do with my life. So she's definitely like a big influence on me, like actually going and pursuing it. So.
Well, because you saw, you felt the way you knew how it made you feel.
Yeah. And I wanted
and now to. Now you're able to do that and give people that feeling because I don't think you can get it from anything else. You know, a movie, you can kind of get emotional, but to me, music, it seeps into your soul and it literally can just grab you. And you guys, you two ladies have that ability. I mean, your harmonies, your sound is just, it's beautiful. It's almost haunting. Sounds so great together.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Heather Lee says, great song. Yeah.
Thank you,
Heather. So y'all have a little surprise for us. Are we still going to plan on doing that?
We'll have to take the headphones off to do it.
So ladies and gentlemen, Jerry, you want to tell them or shall I?
They are going to honor us by playing a live song. They're going to play for us live tonight.
And
I understand we got to take the headphones off since we're, you know, not in your studio tonight. But, because if you kept them in, I'd keep saying things to kind of throw you off track.
Yeah, me too. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take myself off the screen, Jerry off the screen. Jerry, we're going to mute our mics, please. And we're going to give them the whole stage. Y'all take your time. You will have the whole screen. No pressure. No rush. I'll try not to jump in and say anything. Jerry, sweet hats off to the ladies. Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So Jerry and I are going to go in the waiting room. Jerry, this won't hurt too bad. I'm just going to kind of push you over there. Here we go. Ready?
All right.
It's hard enough kicking myself out.
While you're getting the guitar ready, I'll just kind of tell them a little bit about. Sure. Yeah.
Tell them about the song.
So
I'd like to personally dedicate it to my mama because she's watching.
So this song is called Wild Card, and it's the title track to our most recent EP, which we released basically a year ago this past week on the 10th, 11th. And it's about not giving up hope on love. And we wrote it with a really awesome writer named Olivia Baker. And you can find it on all the streaming things and all of the fun stuff. And we, I don't know what else.
I think that's probably it.
Okay, we're gonna
take headphones out so we won't hear y'all, but you hopefully
we'll
hear
see
us.
Ya. Okay.
It's a risk, then call me a gambling woman. I roll the dice and lost one too many times. But I double down, order around, play another hand. When they all fold, I tell them let it ride. 'Cause I know in my soul, somewhere the house is full. joke is only there to make you laugh. The king shows all his cards, and he's only holding hearts of a hurler in love, guilty is charged. It's a wild card. If learning the hard way is cool, baby, I'm your girl. Calling a bluff is something I don't do well. But out on a limb, I go all in, though I have yet to win. The heart on my sleeve is always my biggest tell. But I know in my soul, somewhere the house is full. And the joke is only there to make you laugh. The king shines all his cards, and he's only holding hearts of a high roller in love, guilty is charged. It's a wild card. I'll play till I find my two of a kind. 'Cause I know in my soul, somewhere the house is full, and the joke is only there to make you laugh. Yeah, I know in my soul, somewhere the house is full, and the joke is only there to make you laugh. The king shows all his cards, and he's only holding hearts. I'm a hireler in love, guilty as charged. It's a wild card. It's a wild card. I'm a wild card.
Go ahead and jump back on the chat.
Da-da-da-da. Let's get back. Oh my gosh. We really need an applause button. Oh my goodness.
No.
Ladies, that was so beautiful. And the fact that you did that just spur of the moment, you sounded so good. And more than that, I can see how much joy you have just singing with each other and entertaining people. I love the smiles on your face. What a great song. Oh, thank you. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Heather says great vocals. Love that
song. Thank you, Heather. Thank you,
Marie. Marie said, love it. I put up the comments sometimes.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you,
man. Oh my gosh. How sweet. Let's see. Jerry, go ahead. What you got to say, sir?
Well, I'm kind of sitting here in my studio. I've got my vocal booth behind me. I got my mixer over here. We've got our microphones right over here. That was dry. For those that don't know what that means, it means they used no equipment whatsoever, no reverberation, no compression, no tweaking. That was just straight up guitar and singing and was absolutely amazing. If I ever tried to do something dry like that, I would sound, I'd lose every fan I ever had. So
I agree with you. That's with nothing. That is just your beautiful and incredible voices. I mean, you sounded really, really good together, ladies. I mean, you can't pretend when you're going live like that. I mean, that was them live. You know what I mean? You can't hide behind it.
True. Yeah. We all got real used to doing live streams over COVID.
We did. Yep. And you just go with it, whatever happens.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And I love that. Oh my gosh. Y'all sounded really, really good. Let me see what Marie said. Love it. Let me see what this is. The voice hit it just right. Yes.
All right.
I agree. Oh my goodness.
We're going to call both of our voices together. The voice.
The voice.
You know what? It almost is like, well, to me, it almost is like one voice because y'all blend together so beautifully. The harmonies are just perfect. So beautiful job, girls. I love that. Stars and heart. Yeah, well earned, well earned. Oh my gosh. I can just, that's Dale. Let's see who else we have here. Maria, making sure I don't miss anything. Jerry, what you got to add, sir? Anything?
Well, I was going to ask a question, and I may mispronounce this, and please forgive me if I do, but you do a song called Sewing Song?
Oh, Sewing Song. Yeah.
And one of the things I want to point out, one of the things I love about that song is Mallory's finger picking is just, you know, we're not really seeing, I mean, you're playing wonderfully, don't get me wrong,
yeah.
But we're not seeing you are so talented with the guitar and can do things that we just wish we could do.
Oh,
and
I appreciate that. Thank you.
And you know, it's funny because as a musician myself, and I like the song, don't get me wrong. I love the lyrics, don't get me wrong. But just being a guitar player myself, I immediately go straight to the, oh, listen to the finger picking. That's awesome, you know. Wow. And then you come in with the harmonies and it's like, oh, you know, just be still my heart, you know.
So, and what song is, what is that song called again?
It's called Sowin' Song.
Yeah, that's a tune that we really wanted to lean into when we play it live, especially. We were really inspired by like Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young and kind of the Laurel Canyon artists of the 70s, the late 60s and the early 70s. And I don't know, that song was a thing that was started at a writing retreat with a good friend of ours, Chris Bradley, who we also wrote Fool's Gold with. And I had that hook for that song, the You Ain't Nothing But a Leaf on My Tree, was like meant to be kind of like a bluesy, but baby, you ain't nothing but a leaf on my tree. And that I wanted it to be more of kind of like a Delta blues thing. And she heard it and she was just like, you know what? No, this needs to be like straightforward and it needs to be something that's really heartfelt. Like I can like feel the pain in it. And I was like, I don't know what you mean. And she just kind of started to come up with a couple of the chords for the chorus. And the minute I heard her sing it, actually, I was like, oh, that is the song. And so we wrote the first couple of verses and a chorus and it just sat there for forever. And I remember on a particular fall day when I was feeling in a particular mood that wasn't good. I sat there and I thought about something that had ended that really was, you know, hard on me and hard on my heart. And I honestly, like, I felt like the song came to me and through me. It wasn't something that I created. It was like, I happened to be like paying attention for whatever reason
and
in that
writing
moment.
It down or playing it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So it just kind of, I think as songwriters, we are conduits and we receive things sometimes and it comes through us. And that's a song where I really don't feel like I can take much credit for it because it came from somewhere else and I just happened to be tuned to that frequency at that moment. So,
well, and Samhain is, we spell it sort of more phonetically, but it's the actual spelling of it and what the festival is a Celtic festival of harvest. It's essentially like Halloween or just like the ending of that season,
yeah,
the beginning of a new season. And so it's ending.
The darkness is coming
yeah.
and everyone's getting ready for winter.
Oh,
and
there's the changing of the season and the harvest and yeah.
Yeah, and it just, you know, that I always just picture the little golden leaf on the tree, the final leaf that blows away. And you're kind of like, wow, that's so beautiful, but it's so fleeting. But it stays, things like that stay with you. And so that's, I don't know, maybe I got too deep, but that's, that song's near and dear to my heart.
That is true, to equate the falling leaf to ended love. Wow. I'm going to have to go look at that. I'm absolutely, as soon as I get done here, I'm going to go look up your other songs. So folks, we need to take a quick break because I want to have a word from our sponsor real quick. Here at Carolyn's Corner, we have a wonderful sponsor that's local here. And by the way, our friend Troy earlier said, have them play at the VFW. I would love. Anytime you
want
to come
so
to
fun.
Yeah, we'll have to hit you up when we're coming through Texas.
Absolutely.
Boy, I don't know if you're still here, but wouldn't that be something? They'd be like, who are these ladies?
Anytime we can play for the plate of VFW or USL or anything like that, we're down.
Yes, absolutely. I wish you were closer. Of course, I would love to have you anytime, but I don't know if you'd be willing to make the trip all the way to Texas for that, but it would be wonderful. But we have another sponsor, called Scores Bar and Grill here in Bevo. It's another small, it's a fairly large establishment that also has singers and songwriters come in on occasion and bands come in. So it's just a nice little venue, very nice atmosphere. And I'm very honored to say they're our sponsor. So I'd like to play this little video just real quick. It's not even 30 seconds. And then we'll be right back, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, did you hear the great news? Scores Bar and Grill right here in Beeville at 1502 North St. Mary Street is now open 7 nights per week. That's right. Scores is open 7 nights per week starting at 5 p.m. With nightly specials, open mic every Wednesday, karaoke the first Saturday of every month. You can check them out by going to their Facebook page at Scores Bar Beeville. Go check it out. You'll be so glad you did. There we go, and we are back. Thank you again to our sponsor, Scores. So Marie said she wishes John would get them to do the Crossroads Country Opry. Yeah, they have a cool thing that they do down in Victoria, Texas. And I know it's a long drive, but it's really neat. They have different, it's mostly country, but different artists come on and sing with the house band. And it's really fun. Yeah, I'm glad I tuned in. Great.
We'll, we'll have to hit you up about that when we are coming through. Because we're, like I said, we're going to be in Austin in October. So we're maybe
we'd love to make it some, around, yeah, you know, anywhere else in Texas too.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're, I don't even know, we're a couple hours from Austin. I was trying to raise my chair up while ago. My husband walked in the door and said, raise your chair up. I look like a little girl down here because my chair keeps getting lower and lower. And I was trying to do it. I forgot to do it during the,
like
the commercial wasn't long enough.
I love it.
Yeah. So hello to Gary Ward. Gary Ward is another past podcast guest. Gary is an incredible guitarist and musician. I mean, you can check him out. He's got some beautiful stuff. Man, this guy rocks. Really, really good. Thanks for being here, Gary. It's always an honor to have you guys coming back on the show, and I'm glad to see you're with us. For everyone that's tuning in, yeah, talk to John. You never know, Marie. You never know. This is a really big VFW, too. In, hey, and then you could go, you can make the VFW circuit. Maybe.
Yeah. Hey. Hey. Yeah, we do house concerts, too. So, yeah, we're open to lots of different kinds of things.
Yes. Marie, I'll give you their contact information, or they can probably message you on your website. Okay. Tell them how to contact you.
You can find our contact info on our website, but the main email that we use for booking shows is bookingcrimsoncalamity@gmail.com. And you'll either get a hold of one of us or our sometimes manager, Amy, who books shows for us.
Awesome. So there you go, Marie. And I can also put you in contact with them too. Jerry, anything you want to add, sir? Gosh, I can't. No, I wish you would come to, that'd be incredible.
Yeah, now, yeah, we're starting to get late, pushing time a little bit, but I will say, you know, when you listen to them, they don't fit the mold of Nashville country.
That's true.
But one of the things I have quickly come to learn is that, with the exception of adult contemporary music, country's not all country. Christian's not all Christian. Pretty much it's, you know, if it's good, we love it.
Yep. Genre is kind of dead a little bit.
Absolutely. That's what we were talking about earlier. Literally everything is a mixture of everything now. I mean, except for your very traditional country, you know, It is. To me, it's all mixed. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Okay, Marie. I don't know if they can get that right now, but I will. Yeah. I will forward that to them.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes, thank you. Please do.
Taking a stand on this is what we're going to play, as far as, you know, being real country sounding.
Right.
But it's just it. You know, when we're dealing with and you know, I'm a Christian songwriter. Yeah. In dealing with other songwriters that are Christian or country, they just the country songwriters just seem to be the nicest people in the world. Just, you know, even more so sometimes than the very Christian singers.
Well, the and also, I mean, I think Nashville's kind of the hub for the CCM, like, hub too. I think
it is a hub for
but,
sure.
But it could be really. I've heard stories, yeah, about how tough it is, and it's like, you know, really strict guidelines and everything like that, which, you know, it is what it is. But I definitely feel like Nashville in general is a very, I mean, it's a songwriter town. It's very collaborative. And, you know, there's
there's natural competition everywhere, I think. But what I like about Nashville.
I wouldn't say competition. It's, we're just like, you know, there's like that kind of stuff everywhere. But I feel like, yeah.
I just feel like Nashville, it's Nashville simultaneously is inclusive of all genres of music, but it also has high standards.
Mm.
And so it's like, all right, if you're going to play, then you better really play. If you're going to write, then you better make it a good one. And it's not really spoken about. It's just sort of presented in the talent that's around, and you get inspired and you say, that made me feel something. I want to write a song like that. And it's a continual thing.
The song is what's
thing.
Important. And it's
the town is an influence.
Yeah. And right, it's about the craft.
It's kind of like when an actor or actress goes to Hollywood.
Yeah.
I guess it's kind of the same thing. There's so many.
Or you
have to really, I mean, you have to be great. You have to be, that's what I've always heard. You know, you keep seeing this on the shows. You know, if you're going to, you know, it's hard to make it in Nashville.
Yeah.
It's hard to make it in Hollywood.
It's a lot about who you know everywhere, but you also have to be good. And you have to, like I said, show up on time. And be,
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and that goes a long way, your work ethic.
Jerry does have some great songs, Maria.
Yes, he does.
He sure does. He sure does. We played his songs, one of his songs on the radio show on Monday. And
Speaking
of that, I would be honored if you'd like us to play at least one of your songs on the radio show this coming Monday. Would y'all?
Please, we would
be honored. That would be fabulous.
Okay, absolutely. I will definitely do that. I'll let you know in advance about what time we're going to play in case you're able to tune in, because we do Facebook Live at the same time. It's hilarious because it drives us crazy. Every time we try to do Facebook Live, which we do, we can't turn the music up in the radio station because Facebook will mute us because I'm on this Facebook. So it's a constant battle. So we stream live to, of course, the radio's website as well. So it's a live stream through Live 365. So I always tell them, you can go over there and listen and stay here to watch.
I love it.
So heads up, I probably won't be able to turn it up in the station because they always block us and mute us.
It's like a listening party.
It drives me crazy. I'm like, how can we overcome? We tried. I've tried for over a year and I'm like, well, never mind. I'm not going to keep trying. But it would be my honor to play at least one of your songs.
Oh, we would love that. Thank you.
Fabulous.
You're welcome. I'm so blessed to be able to do it. Do you have a preference on which one you'd rather I play? If not, I'm just going to select.
You can totally select.
We're cool with you picking. We'd like you to play your favorite, whatever resonates with you.
That's impossible to choose. Well, what I'll do is I'll take a vote from a few of our loyal listeners and get them to help me select their favorite that we play.
I love that.
Fool's gold.
Fool's gold. Musical democracy.
Okay, so that's one. I guess that's one vote for Fool's Gold. I wish I could play them all. We have time, but we get overwhelmed with too many songs if we start.
Yeah.
Doing like three or four songs from each artist, and that quickly got a little bit out of hand. So I said we're gonna have to narrow this down, and I thought we could make it almost like a contest. Okay. Which song do you vote for, Marie? Which song do you vote for? You know, and so forth.
Love that.
So we'll do that. I'll reach out to them. And Jerry already gave his, he said Fool's Gold. I barely heard him. He was like muffled, but.
Oh, and my Aunt Barry. Wow. My aunties are just like, they're bringing
the
it home
fam
today.
Now.
Hi,
oh,
Aunt
that's
Barry.
So great. I don't know why I'm not seeing them. I don't know why I'm not seeing the chat anymore. Are you still seeing it over there?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Something must
no
have
worries.
Happened. Well, that's okay. Oh, there we go. And that's Marie. No, love them.
The puppet song is so cute. My best friend.
The puppet song is so cute. So, Marie, are you going with the puppet song?
I hope it gets
you. What's going to happen is we're going to have too many. Everybody's going to like, I like them all. How are we going
to my best friends. Yeah.
Oh,
Marie,
that's so
Maria, so I love her to death. She's a wonderful fan.
Yeah, she is. Yeah. She's always supporting everyone. She really is amazing. Wow, that puppet song is so cute. Yeah, I like that. What is called the puppet song? It is really cute. It's really, really cute. So, ladies, gosh, it's already after 9. Time always goes by so fast.
I know. Because
we're trying to get as much done as we can in a very short time. Ladies, it has been a pleasure to have you here. And I really do mean that a big pleasure, like an honor. Because I your talent is just so immense. It really is. And I know you're going to make a big statement out there in the world. And I know you're going to keep going and moving forward and moving up. And I wish you nothing but the best. I can't wait to see you on a big stage, like a big, huge stage somewhere. Make sure you please keep in touch with us. Share whatever you got coming out new and I'll share it. Any new songs, please share. Anytime you're able to come back, let me know. I would love to have you back for a new release or anything like that. And just know that you're part of our crazy family. That's what I say, our crazy dysfunctional family.
Thank you so much for having us. And pleasure was all ours, really.
Pleasure was ours.
Oh, you are so welcome. And Marie is a card dropper. So she goes everywhere to these. She goes, honestly, everywhere. She goes all over the state. She said, send me cards. So if you have any cards, send them my way.
Yeah, hold on. Let me show you our cards. They're so cool. Hold on.
You're gonna like these cards. Okay.
They're wild cards.
One more for the road. Gary said one more for the road. Gary.
That's up to y'all. I don't know if you're out of time or. For some time. Maybe we can just come back another time. Maybe.
We could do that. I mean, if you're up for it, I'm fine with it. If you want to do another one, I'm fine with it. I could listen to you all night. Everyone needs to go to Aunt Dee's Country Kitchen in Yorktown tomorrow to hear Vicky Cross. Yes, Vicky is incredible.
So we took playing cards, and they're really cool. They're like black and gold.
Cool.
And they're kind of like thicker. And then we took our QR code and sticker. And it's holographic, and we put them on the back, and that's our business cards.
So smart. So they just have to scan that code. That's the new generation. That is so cool. I love that. Very clever. Well, I love playing poker. Texas Hold'em is my game.
There you go.
Love it.
Yeah. So that just like, I love it. I love it. That's a cool calling card. Literally a calling card. I love it. I love it. Gary, thank you so much. I guess we're going to go ahead and cut it off tonight. If y'all want to play one more, you're more than welcome. I know I don't want to put you on the spot. Jerry, it was so awesome having you here. Marie said, I'm with Jerry. One more for the road. Send me cards. Love those.
Sound, since we talked about it.
You want to
do that?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, give me a sec to get that guitar.
That's awesome. Gary said his business cards were guitar picks. Great idea.
Yeah. Mallory.
I did want to say on a personal note, thank you so much for being there. You know, you were two of my favorite artists, outside of some Christian artists, you're right there.
Thank you, Jerry. Thank you for inviting us and for introducing us. And
I am so sad that I missed like a whole half hour.
I know. I felt so bad. I was like, how much he's been looking forward to this. And I said, well, I hope and pray he's watching and listening. So Jerry, I'm so glad you're doing one more thing.
She's just tuning right now, but we're going to do Samhain song because we talked about it. So
I want to hear that. Oh my gosh, I was going to go watch it anyway, but now I don't have to. I mean, I'm going to watch it anyway because I want to see your Okay, I'm going to put us in the waiting room, Jerry. Here we go. I'm so excited. Here we go.
Aren't meant to stay. Seasons pass and people change. It might hurt, but that's okay. Some things aren't meant to stay. Honey, you can't leave. It don't faze me. My roots run deep. I'll be fine. Cause you ain't nothing but a leaf on my tree. Get in with the spring, gone with the breeze. You'll turn yellow when it starts to freeze. Then I'll take my branches and shake you from here. Cause honey, you ain't nothing but a leaf on my tree. Your love is bittersweet. It comes on strong, but it leaves me weak. It's all I want and all I don't need. Cause baby, your love is bittersweet. And honey, you can't. That chill might stay, but my roots run deep, and I'll be fine. Cause you ain't nothing but a leaf on my tree. Getting with the spring, gone with the breeze. You'll turn yellow when it starts to freeze, then I'll take my branches and shake you from me. Cause honey, you ain't nothing but a leaf on that tree. Ooh, ah, ooh. Meant to be is sometimes short and sweet. So as the air grows cold and you turn gold, I'll set you free. Cause you ain't nothing but a leaf on my tree. Now I'm watching you slip away from me. But you'll float on as a memory. I'll make new ones in the spring. Honey, I'll make new ones in the spring.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
We're hot mess. Hot mess Mallory over here. Sorry,
y'all. Oh my gosh, ladies. That song is so cool. I love the lyrics of that. I love what you did with that. Oh my God. I really like that. Like, thank go you. On. I'll be fine. I'll be fine. But you're just a leaf on my tree. How cool is that? And I think that's true for a lot of people. You get to a spot in your life at one time or another, as you know, as years go by, you're just like, okay, it was just a leaf on my tree. It was just a drop in the bucket. It was just a memory. It was just an experience. You know what I mean? I love it. Oh my God. I love that song. My sister's in here clapping too.
Oh, thank you.
I know, it's beautiful, isn't it? That was beautiful. Oh my God. Let me minimize this so I get back to the comments. Wow. Very nice. Gary said, very nice. Thanks. Oh, see, Gary, I'm glad you asked. You're so sweet. Golly. I hope you and your wife are doing well. I'm so glad you're here. Gosh, darn ladies, man, I'm so honored to have had you here. I mean that with all my heart. You are so talented, so
thank
gifted.
You.
Yeah, and so blessed. I mean, honestly, you can just see the love between you guys. I can tell that you love what you're doing. You love, I mean, you just have a passion for it. I just love watching you guys smiling. I keep saying it, but smiling while you're singing. I mean, it's just what you're meant to do. God puts you where you're supposed to be. I believe that. Jerry,
thank
what you
have
you. To say? You're welcome.
The only thing I'm going to say is that the, you know, emotions in their singing just come so naturally.
Yeah.
You know, it's, I'd rather have somebody that's a little pitchy and you can feel the emotion. Not that you're pitchy. You're not pitchy.
Sometimes.
Can't
don't
feel
put it past us. Everybody is once
I mean,
in one.
You feel the emotions of the songs. It's just
ice in it.
Amazing how
I'm
they.
I'm sorry. I just spilled. I'm so sorry.
Here, Mallory. Through them.
Yeah. I agree. Brett just said he's going to play that one on the radio for sure. So looks like you're going to be the exception to the rules, lady. It looks like we're going to be playing two of your songs.
Well, we would be honored. That would be amazing. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. My gosh, I don't know. I love them all, and I really do mean that. But if I had to pick my favorite, it would be that one you just played, because that's, I mean.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, gosh, the lyrics to that. And I can tell by the lyrics that it's something that you were dealing with at the moment, because I mean, you literally have to go to that place to write a song like that. I think you have to be
you
in
do.
That moment.
Definitely do. You have moments where you channel something that affected
yes.
you in a profound way. And,
wow.
and sometimes it comes out in a song and
it's beautiful.
Glad you like it.
That yeah. It's beautiful. And I'll be all right. I love that. You're going to get through it. Yeah. It's what we tell everyone. Every week I tell them, hold on through the bad because the good will come back around. Because sometimes
absolutely.
When you're going through a hard time, right? Sometimes it feels like it's never going to get better. But if you just hold on for dear life and just keep one little tiny step in front of the other, eventually you start seeing, and you know,
exactly.
that's the weird part, right, guys? You don't even hardly see it. You just
right.
look back and you're like, well, wait a minute. I made it through that. You know, that's what it's been my
yeah.
experience. You know?
Absolutely.
Yeah. You're like, wow, I can't believe I survived something that I thought I would never survive.
Yeah,
wow.
for sure.
That's incredible. Jerry, I got to quit talking for a minute. Go ahead, Jerry.
No, I mean, again, it's a beautiful night. I don't want to hold these ladies up. Just absolutely amazing. They know I love them, and I love what they do. I just have to say I love who you are and what you do. And just thank keep you. Being who you are and keep doing what you do.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely amazing.
Thank you guys for having us. This was really wonderful. And thank you to everybody who tuned in.
Okay, somebody says, hello, Carolyn and Jerry. Arizona is streaming in. Well, hello, Arizona.
What's up, Arizona?
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here. Everybody, before you leave, if you haven't already, please like, comment, and share. Share is so important. You cannot believe how many more people that's going to get to watch these beautiful ladies and get their word out there, their music out there, their sound out there. Man, I'm wishing nothing but the best for you guys. Well, thank you so much.
We have over 3,000 streams from last.
Yes, Monday? And I think it had, the only thing I see different is we had like 7 people share. And I thought, my God, if that's 7 people sharing.
Imagine if you imagine 15, what,
20 people.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. That's amazing. I had to put 100. It on Facebook because I was like, look what we did. To me, it's we. To me, it is, because we can't do it by ourselves. And I thought, wow, look at all these people that have the opportunity to see these great guests or whatever, you know? So
yeah.
We're going to keep going up and upward and onward. I saw my husband somewhere. So thank you so much
again. Next time I come to Nashville, I expect, well, at least maybe a lunch or something.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I know he's close.
Anytime y'all visit, let us know.
Yeah, for
absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely. And thank y'all so much for tuning in, ladies, gentlemen. Remember, try to be kind to others if you can, please. It's pretty easy to do. God bless you. If you're going through a hard time, hold on. It'll get better. Crimson Calamity, thank you so much. Jerry Bradley, love you. Y'all take care. Good night.
Thank you. Thank you so
much.
Good night,
everyone.
Good night.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.